Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be continuing our classes in learning Photoshop. If you've missed the class so far, today you're going to pick up a lot. And to get started, I'm going to quickly share my screen. Okay, so all our classes, like we all know, we already have them in our website, www.tclassify.com. Once you get there, click on blog. All the commands that you need to write, those commands, I brought them out in such a way that it will be easier for you to use. That's why I put them up here. So if you scroll down to Photoshop, stack up, then you click on it. Okay, so these are the steps. And this contains all we've learned so far, how you set up your workspace, and you continue. Okay. How to use the pen tool. So the lecture we did last was how to make an object disappear. So we got off to blurring, and the blurring was giving us hard time doing. So we'll just go through it now, finish it up so that we can learn how to make a logo using Photoshop. So the first thing we do is to bring in an image by clicking on File, Open. So we'll get to our Photoshop. This is our Photoshop, and this is where we are working. So I've already, for the benefits of those people that are just starting today, I said that this is the main menu. This is the property bar for the property that you, for the object that you've chosen. If you choose a circle, you'll be seeing things concerning the circle here. This is the toolbar, the tools that you use in working. This side is where we have the layer tab. This is the place for effects. And if you want to create a new layer, and this is your work area. So to bring in the work we want to do now, I'm going to quickly go to File, Open. That is the first instruction, File, Open. If you get to our website, you see, bring in the image by simply saying File, Open. That's the first thing you do. So I'm going to go here. So once you click File and Open, you will see this box. So go to where you kept the image you want to work with. So my image is my, where did I leave my image? My image is in Documents. So I'm going to click here to get to Documents. Documents, that's where I kept my image. That's why I'm going there. And desktop folders, Studio Pic, that's the name. So Studio Pics. Okay, so I'm going to pick out one of these images. So let's say I pick out this one and click on Open. So this image will come up here now. Okay, so if you did not follow our classes all the while, we are just repeating it now, or want to get it to completion this time around. So if you had practiced that first one, you did not get. If you're practicing this one, now you get. That's the essence of what we are doing here. If you try it the first time and you did not get it, or you're not very good with the environment, the next time we do it, we revise some of the things we've done before, so you get to do it better. And that's why it's very important that you follow up the class, follow the class up. Once you follow up the class, you find out that all these things are very simple. But if you're not practicing when others are practicing, it becomes difficult, okay? So you can see the image is here now. So what is the next thing I do? Get to the site. You see the next instruction will be to what? Make sure that you unlock it. Make sure that you unlock this very, you can see this is the background, it's locked. How do you know that it's locked? Because of this key icon. Can you see the key icon? So this key icon is showing that it is locked. So how do you unlock it? You double click on this key icon, it will come out here. So put the name of this layer. I'm still gonna name it as what? Background. Then I'm gonna try to pick out a color, red. Then I press OK. So once you do that, you see that this, you see the lock has gone out. And this is now red, and this is still background. Is that clear? That's what you do. So what is the next thing you do after that? You create a new layer by going down close to F of X and clicking new layer. So when you get here to create a new layer, go down here. This is FX showing the effect tab. So go down here, you're gonna see where they write create new layer. So if you hover your cursor, you are gonna see it, create new layer. Can you see it there? So I'm gonna click there. So you can see the new layer, layer one is now up there. So what is the next line of action? Click the pen tool or press P Then select what you want to take out. That's the next thing. So I'll go back here. So I'll go to what? I'm still on the new layer that I just drew. Make sure you're on the new layer by just clicking on it. Then click on the pen tool. Can you see the pen tool here? This is your pen tool. Once you hover it, it will write pen tool. So once I click on that pen tool now, I will now select the person I want to take out. So let me take out the last person, which is this person here. So I'll just go just a little bit close to him. Then I'll keep selecting. That's how you take him out. Okay. So this is pretty easy. So I'm going to try to take him out. So make sure that you're not just too close to him. Or make sure you're taking him out. So I'm going to select right around him. So when you're selecting, once you get to the last place you started, you just put it inside the box and click. If you don't do it like that, it will not select well. So once you do it well, you're going to see that you now have a single line written drawn around the object. So I'm going to right click inside that very object. And I click on make selection. Very important, make selection. Then once the dialog box comes up, make sure you have 0.1 pixel and make sure that you have anti-alias checked and new selection checked. Then click the OK. Once you do that, you see that line over it will not be coiled. It will not be doing as if it's blinking and whirling around. So that is that. So what is the next line of action? So I've right-clicked inside and click make selection, and I've selected the various 0.1 and layers. The next thing will be to click on the stamp tool. You understand? After clicking on the clone stamp tool, not just stamp tool, call it the clone stamp tool, then we'll click holding alt and selecting to sample and paint out. So that's the next thing. So the next thing now will be to what? This is the stamp tool. But before you do this one, please make sure that you're on the background layer. Make sure that you're on the background layer. So once you're on the background layer, click on this clone stamp tool. If you hover over it, you will see the name clone stamp tool, or you can simply press S. That's the shortcut. So once I click on it, I will now have to sample. What color do I want to cover here with? The color that you cover here with, paint out here with, will be based on what is on the background, because you don't want it to be noticed. So I'm going to hold down the shift or alt key, the alt key on your keyboard. Check where there is alt. Hold it down and click. So once you hold down and click, you've selected. You know, you see that the white now is covering this. So I can now come here and click and hold down to paint it out. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm painting it out because I want to take out that man. Okay. So paint it out. So paint out as much as you can. Once you're painting out and the paint is no longer coming, what do? You go back again, hold down the alt, and do what? Sample again. You press. So once you sample, you go and click and hold down and remove the color. You're painting out. Okay? Once it stops having effect, you go back again. Do what? Sample by holding the alt and clicking. See the way we are doing it? Very simple, very effective. So once it stops bringing an effect, you go back again, sample. So sampling is something that you continue doing. Don't do once and say, hey, it's no longer working. So keep sampling. That's the only way you do it, by keeping sampling. It's not only once that you sample. You sample, come back, you sample, come back. That's how it works. So I'll go back again, go down the shift, alt key, I normally mistake alt for shift. So the key is alt, not shift. So let me sample this side. So you can sample any side you want. So let me sample here again. See the way it's coloring, because I sampled part of that place. So it's your background that you're supposed to sample. Are we clear on this? Can you see that the sampling is almost done well? So I'll sample again. Okay. So I almost have what I want. Good. Okay, so I think we are good to go now, Abi. Are we good to go? Okay, so I think I'm good to go. So after sampling, what's the next thing to do? Very, very important. I think that this is where we missed the steps the last time. So the next thing will be to use the blood tool to blend it out so that we don't notice the difference. Why are we using blood tool? We don't want to notice the difference between here and here, this boundary. We want to make sure that this boundary is taken out. So how do you do that? We simply click the blood tool, but first of all, make sure you make the layers. That's the first thing you do. You make the two layers. So how do you make the layer? Make sure you click one of them, then you click the other one by holding down the shift key. So once you hold the shift key, you click the both of them and right click and say what? Merge layers. Can you see merge layers? So the two layers are now the same thing. They are now the same thing. That's the first thing you do. Okay. So after merging the layers, now what do? You now select select the right size of the brush, then you blend out. So very important, there's an important instruction that is not on this, which I'm going to give you now that will help you out. So once you're done, what you do first is that you click here. Can you see this selection? This a rectangular marquee tool. So click on it once, then come inside here, inside the, what you selected before, right click and deselect. So right click and deselect. So once you deselect, you see now you're no longer seeing that mark around it. You understand? That is when you can now apply your blurring and your blurring will now be effective. Is that clear? So once you've deselected, you can see even, you might not even want to do blurring again. It's almost good. But blurring is very, very important. So to blur, you click on this tool. This is the blur tool. I'm hovering over it so that you see there written blur tool. So blur tool, click on this blur tool. Then select the size you want. So hardness, you can leave it to be very small. For this size, make sure you pick a sizable size. And now press enter key. Press the enter key, okay? So you can see it now. Now you can blur. You can see the blur now is now effective, it's coming out now. So blur by continuously shedding. Continuously shedding blurs it out. So if you blur and you did not see the effect you want, just continuously shed it. It's gonna blur out, okay? If you're looking at where I'm blurring now, you can see that those changes there, they are no longer there. It has blended in. So as you're blurring, depending on the effects you're having, you can see that this place, I did not shed out here very well. I did not take out this very, very well. So this place, I should have taken it out when I was painting out. But you can see that the blurring is very, very effective now. If you look at this other side now, there's no evidence showing that anybody was cut out from here. So I'll come down here. This is the last place that I needed to blur well. So I keep shedding. Once you keep shedding, the blurring will be happening. So you can also try to increase your hardness if you want. Okay. Okay. So this is perfect. This is so sweet and so good. And if you are doing your own, make sure that you take out all this place. These are evidence showing that somebody was taken out here. So you make sure you shed out when during your painting using the clone stamp tool, make sure you take out all this place. Okay, so I'm almost done shedding out. If you want to see it very well and shed out well, you can come down here to zoom and increase the zoom. So I'm gonna click the selection, press escape. My system is hanging. Okay, so that's about how to do it. I hope this one is a better and a clearer class today. So please try it out. If you have any question, you ask me. Everybody, try it out now. Try it out. If you don't have CorelDRAW, get CorelDRAW installed in your system and try it out. Okay. Thank you. Remember, everything you want is in Christ Jesus. And the surest way to success is by being a born again. See you when I see you. Thank you very much.